rafiki na wanaweza kugeuka.
Mara kwa mara,
kwa mara,
adui walizunguka.
Nitaishi kwa aliyeko Bwana, uniachi,
uniachi.
Thank you very much. Asanteni sana. Kwa niaba ya mke wangu na familia yetu, nataka niwakaribishe nyote katika makao haya, karibuni sana. Nataka pia niwashukuru kwa kupata ama kuchukua muda wenu ili mje katika ibada hii ya shukrani ambayo tulipanga ya kwamba iwe ni Jumapili ya kwanza baada ya sisi kuapishwa. Haikuwezekana Jumapili iliyopita kwa sababu tulikuwa safarini, lakini tulikubaliana na familia yangu ya kwamba this will be the service that we are going to thank God for what he has done to us. So welcome friends, welcome everybody to this Thanksgiving service because of what God has done to us. As I said, we are a product of prayer, and we are here because of prayer. I want to thank many. I know many people, many even we don't know, who prayed for us, many who fasted, people we don't know their names. Yesterday, as I was coming home, I met an Indian lady, and she came and told me, I prayed for you. And it was just amazing. I don't know her. I've never met her, but it just reminded me that there were many people who prayed for our country. So we have come here to thank God for the victory of our nation. It is not a victory of those who won the election. It is a victory for Kenya to have a peaceful election, to have an election like no other. We are being celebrated across the world for a peaceful, transparent election. And all glory go to God. I know many of you have visited me once or twice in different places. We have met in your churches. We have met in many meetings. Some of you have come to Karen to pray for us. Some of you have come to Karen for other meetings. And I remember, those of you who came to Karen, I told you that I extended actually an invitation to you. I told you that you're welcome to Statehouse. And that was many months, some of it last year, and it was by faith. Na Mungu ametutendea. So I am very happy that I have kept my promise to welcome those of you who we met to Statehouse. I was in Pastor Mwai's church the other day, just about several weeks ago, and I remember telling his congregation, nitawaalika kule ikulu. Na mambo ilikuwa bado. Si unaona sasa Pastor Mwai mambo imekuwa. So, karibuni sana, tunamshukuru Mungu kwa sababu ametutendea haya mambo makuu. So we thank God for everything. Thank you, our spiritual fathers. Thank you, Mom Wairimu and the spiritual mothers who are here. Thank you very much for standing in the gap for our nation. Thank you for praying for us. And I want to tell you the words of Galatians 6:9. Do not tire in doing good. Ile mahali mumefanya mambo mazuri kutuombea, endeleeni kutuombea na kuombea taifa letu la Kenya. Kwa sababu kuna malipo mtapata. Mungu, God is going to reward you in due time. That's what the word of God says. Let me also say how grateful I am to the many leaders who have come to join us in this Thanksgiving service. In a very special way, let me recognize my good brother Musalia Mudavadi. He's in our midst. Asante sana, Mheshimiwa. The Speaker of our National Assembly, Moses Wetangula. Those two brothers came to join us when things were difficult. And we want to thank God for them. I want to thank my brother Alfred Mutua, is in the house. He also came to join us when things were tough, and we formed a big team together. Let me, in a very special way, thank my team, the men and women of David, as my wife normally calls them. The people we came with from Jubilee Party, and we came to UDA. They are right here. Ebu simameni. Iyo jeshi yote hiyo. Awa ndio tulitoka na wao huko. So, asanteni sana. And they are just a small minority. We have a very big team that we came together. And they stood with us. They worked with us. I know Mom has said something about the Hustler Nation. It wasn't my design. It was God's design. You know, when things got difficult for David, God raised an army for him, you know, in that cave. And he raised hustlers, actually, because these were people with debts. Many of my people are in Fuliza. So many of them had all manner of challenges, you know, and that's the situation we are in Kenya. So whenever I went to church in some areas, there used to be so many people making noise all over the place, the Hustler Nation. And I used to tell the church, please, just bear with me. This is the army God has also given to me. Like the other one of the hustlers in David's situation. But we want to thank God for the millions of people of Kenya who stepped forward. Despite their challenges, despite many things, but they stood firm, and in a way that is amazing, that nobody expected. There are people who are still recovering even today from our win. They never imagined this was possible. Because Goliath was there in full armor, you know, and you can know, we were being told the deep state and the system and everybody. But we thank God that he saw us through. So I want to thank you in a very special way for coming so that we can share this moment with us. And I want in this service, in this state house, to ask leaders and to ask spiritual leaders, to ask our bishops, to ask our spiritual fathers, and all Kenyans, to pray for us. And I specifically want to request three prayer items, because that is what it is. You know, in the Bible, Matthew 25, I think 35 all the way to 45, we are told of this situation where at the fullness of time, we will stand before God and we will be asked a few questions. God will say, I was hungry, you didn't feed me. I was sick, you didn't pay me a visit. I didn't have shelter. And that is the case with our nation today. There are many people who are hungry. There are many people who don't have shelter. There are many people who die because they cannot afford health care. And that is why we crafted a plan. I want to request you to pray for our plan so that to those who are hungry, we can find food for them. And to those who don't have shelter, we can build houses for them. And to those who are sick, we can have a universal health coverage for them. We have put this in our plan. We have put this in our plan. And I want to request you to help me and my team so that when we stand before God, we can not be ashamed. Because you remember the Bible says, if you didn't do it for any one of these little ones, you didn't do it for me. So that even as we work on the plan to make sure that we feed every Kenyan, we are doing it even for Christ. As we look for shelter for the millions who today live in informal settlements and many people who have no shelter, we can be doing it because we are commanded to do good and to find shelter for those who don't have. And even when we work on universal health coverage, it is because we want to look at those who cannot afford health care in our country. And so that in the fullness of time, we can stand before God and say, we did it for fellow humankind. I want to pray that you pray for us, pray for our plan. We have a good plan, but that plan is nothing without God. Prayer item number two, I want you to pray for our economy. We are not in a very good place. I must say this, and I must tell you this. We have debts. We are a country in debt. And you know very well what the Bible says in Proverbs. In Proverbs, and 22 verse 7, says, the rich rule over the poor. And it also says, the borrower is a slave to the lender. As we speak today, we are chained to many debts. 65% of all the taxes we collect, we use to pay debt. That's why I'm asking you to pray for our economy. Remember the words of Deuteronomy 28:12. The Lord says, I will open, told the children of Israel, and I'm sure we can claim the same for our country, Kenya. The Lord told the children of Israel, I will open the treasures of heaven. I will cause rain to be in your land. And more importantly, he said, you will lend to many nations, but you will not borrow from anybody. Today, it is the opposite for us. And I want to pray that the church can pray for a paradigm shift in the economy of our country. We have laid out good plans, and I can see there is light at the end of the tunnel. Things are difficult, but we will succeed because we have God on our side. Please pray for our economy. Please remember to pray for our economy. I said, please remember to pray for our economy. Part of the reason why we have borrowed heavily from others is because we haven't been prudent in savings for our own nation. Our children, you remember the words of Proverbs again, 13:22, which say, a good man leaves an inheritance for his children's children. But the wealth of sinners is stocked up for the righteous. So, instead of us leaving an inheritance for our children, we are leaving debt for our children. And so, we have to be prudent about saving. It's biblical to save. I know there was a ruling this week by the court on matters to do with savings in our country. They have told us to do certain things, including to go back to the Senate so that we can proceed together. That we are going to do because savings is a must. We cannot continue to borrow from the savings of others. If we must borrow, let us borrow from our own savings so that we can pay interest to our own savers. And we can build our country using our own savings. I am very clear, I am very keen, and I'm sure we'll be working with our members of parliament and members of Senate, National Assembly, so that we can provide the framework for Kenya to save, so that we can become good men and women and leave an inheritance for our children. Do you know that everybody who works today in Kenya saves only 200 shillings every month? How much? Not 2,000. Even those who earn 500, 600, 1 million shillings, they save 200 shillings. And somebody has gone to say it should stay like that. That is not what savings is all about. So, we are re-engineering that whole space, and we want every Kenyan to save. Those who are employed, their employers should also match their savings. And those who are not employed, the government of Kenya will save with them. If any Kenyan saves an amount, the government of Kenya will give them money equivalent to a percentage of their saving to become part of their savings. It is the only way we can build the culture of savings. It is biblical. It is the right thing. It is what countries do. And that's the only way we can stop being slaves of our lenders, and we can instead lend to others. Finally, I want you to pray for the peace of our country. Kenya is an anchor state. Many countries. I spoke to many leaders over the last couple of weeks, and they are looking at Kenya to provide solutions for the peace of our region, from Somalia to Ethiopia to DRC to South Sudan and the whole of this region. The world is looking at us as an anchor state to provide solutions for the challenges of peace we have in our nation. But that spirit of conflict, as you all know, has also come to our country. We lost several people and several policemen yesterday and day before in Turkana. We are doing what we must do as a government to make sure that we see the last of these kind of things so that our country can be peaceful and so that Kenya can play its rightful place being the anchor state in this region. So pray for our country so that the spirit of conflict, the spirit of cattle rustling will be defeated. And we are going to work as government to make sure that we deal with that menace, deal with that challenge, so that we can keep peace in our country and make sure that Kenya occupies the place, its rightful place in the community of nations, to provide leadership and to anchor the peace and tranquility of our region. So pray for our forces. Pray for our policemen and women, our security agencies, so that they can discharge their responsibilities. I have already, in the last few weeks, I have given authority for the police to spend, to have their own budget. They don't have to wait for the office of the president anymore. Such challenges, they now have their resources, and they can deploy them in the best way they know how. And I will be demanding of them results, because they always complained that they were curtailed by the fact that they had to look for resources in the office of the president. I have now separated their budget. They are running their own budget. They are running their own plan. They have their own strategy. And we will be demanding from them security of Kenyans, because that is their mandate, and we will be making sure that they deliver on that mandate. But meanwhile, let us pray for the wisdom of God to be upon the men and women who are charged with the security of our nation. Those are the three items I thought I would say in this service. While I promise you that we will now be rolling the wheels of government to make sure that we deliver on all the other issues. Tomorrow, I have asked my deputy to put together the team so that we can work on our drought situation that is threatening many people. We've arranged some food. We're working on with the governors on the ground and other leaders to make sure that no Kenyan dies because of hunger. We want to make sure that that has not happened. So let me leave it there and to say thank you very much for coming. After this service, please don't leave. There is a lunch that is served here. But also, there is still another part two of this service. and the part two of this service is not as organized as part one. So as I told you when we were in Karen, please after lunch, musiondoke apa. Ikiwanja yote, yeah, speak a word of blessing around this compound. And those who can speak in tongues, please speak in tongues around this compound. As we ask, we will ask at least 30 or 40 of our senior clergy to come and pray over this building and pray over these residents. And all of you, musikwe na haraka ya kuondoka, tafadhali. Muzunguke hapa kiwanja yote, karabashanda, nini, kila mahali. Oh, hallelujah. Ndio. Ndio ijulikane wenyewe wamefika. So I will ask mom here and the other spiritual leaders when we finish after lunch. You will arrange yourselves, maybe 30, 40 of you, so that we can pray over the whole building and that kind of thing, and the offices here, so that God can give us solutions for the challenges of our republic. So otherwise, mimi nawapenda sana, nawatakia baraka ya Mungu. Mungu awajalie mambo yote, maombi yenu yote ijibiwe. Mungu awabariki familia zenu, na Mungu awabariki mambo yote, makanisa yenu, and your ministries. May God extend your territories so that you can grow for the glory of God in our nation. Nawatakia kila naheri. Mwisho, mulisikia mama Dokas alisema ya kwamba protocol ikileta shida unaita aliambiwa na Recho ati protocol ikileta shida call your husband. Na pia nataka nimwambie my brother Rigathi Gachagua ya kwamba ukifika mahali, pia ukitaka amani nyumbani, uite bibi yako. So on that note, I want to ask my wife Rachel to
nation, and we know revival has started, oh God. And even the prayer issues that our president has asked us to pray for, praying for the plan, praying for the economy, and praying for the peace of this nation. Father, we know, Jehovah God, that, Lord, you are going to answer those prayers because, Lord, those are the desires of our leaders and the desires of the people of this nation. And so, Father, may you bless us and be with us, for we pray all this in Jesus' name.